In this video, we're going to take a look at how to set up secure store in a SharePoint server farm. I'm going to start here in SharePoint Central Administration, and the first thing that I want to do is to start the secure store service on one of my application servers. Under System Settings, Manage Services on Server, and the first thing that I need to do here is to choose which application server I want to run the secure store service on. So on the server menu, I can click Change Server, and you can see I have two application servers in my farm, and I need to start the secure store service on at least one of them. I can run it on more than one if I want greater availability. Now, because secure store service is dealing with storing credentials in a database, for best security, you may want to consider having an application server in your farm that is just for the secure store service. In my case, I'm going to go ahead and choose App Server 2. And then if I scroll down, you'll see here's the secure store service. And I want to choose Start. If I scroll back down again, you'll see that it is started. Now I'm going to go back to the Central Administration homepage, and the next step is to configure a Secure Store service application. In order to do that, I need an Active Directory account to run the application pool for the Secure Store service. So I'm going to switch over to my domain controller, and I'll go ahead and create the account here. Now, in a larger organization, you'll probably just ask your domain administrator to create an account for you. In this case, I'll go ahead and walk through the steps in case you're doing it yourself. Choose Start, Administrative Tools, Active Directory Users and Computers, right-click Users, New, User. I'm just going to call it Secure Store Account. I'll use the same for user logon name. Click Next. Type in confirm a password, and because this is a service account, I don't want to have to change the password at next login, so I'll uncheck this option, and I'm going to choose password never expires to make this a non-expiring password. If in your organization you use expiring passwords normally, you can go ahead and do that in this case, and SharePoint Server can manage the password changes for you, and I'll show you how that works when we get a little further along. In my case, I'll go ahead and use a non-expiring password. Choose Next, and choose Finish. You can see here's our new application pool account. I'll switch back to my application server. Now, the next thing that I need to do is to register the account that I just created as a managed account in SharePoint Server. So I'm going to choose Security, and then under General Security, Configure Managed Accounts, Register Managed Account, and then I want to type the username of the account that I just created, which in my case was Contoso Secure Store Account, and I'll type the password for that account. Now you can see here is the option to enable automatic password changing, and if you choose to use an expiring password, you can select this option and SharePoint Server will manage the password changes for you. In my case, I chose a non-expiring password, so I'll leave this unselected. Scroll down and click OK. Here's our new Secure Store account, managed account. I'll go back to the Central Administration homepage, and now we can create the Secure Store service application. So under Application Management, choose Manage Service Applications, choose New, Secure Store Service. Type a name. I'm just going to call it Secure Store. Secure Store does use a database where it stores the encrypted credentials. So you'll want to type the name of the instance of SQL Server where you want to create the Secure Store database. Now again, because we're talking about storing credentials here, for best security, you may want to consider a separate instance of SQL Server that you just use for the Secure Store database. In my case, the default of Contoso SQL is the database server that I want to use. The default name is Secure Store Service with a GUID. If you have database naming conventions, or if you'd just rather a different name, you can change that here. Secure Store does support database failover, so if you have database mirroring set up in SQL Server, you can specify the name of the failover server here. Now you do have to have SQL Server mirroring configured in order for this to work. I do want to create a new application pool. I'm just going to call it Secure Store App Pool. And then I need to select the account that will be used to run the application pool. And this is where we want to select the Active Directory account that we created and then registered as a managed account in SharePoint Server. Scroll down. You can see there is an audit log, and by default that's enabled. You can disable it if you want to. In my case, I'm just going to leave it enabled. And click OK. And here you can see the service application was successfully created. So I'll click OK. And here's the new Secure Store service application. Now I'm going to click here. And you'll see there's a message that before I can use this service application, I have to generate an encryption key. So I'm going to click Generate New Key. And I'll type and confirm a passphrase. And click OK. Now that I've generated the key, you can see the new button is available to create a new target application, meaning that Secure Store is now ready for me to use. So that's a quick look at setting up Secure Store on a SharePoint server farm. You can leave feedback on this video or any of our TechNet content by going to the TechNet topic and choosing the rating and feedback control at the bottom of the page. Or you can send feedback to docbi@microsoft.com.